Hello, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Candace and I make all kinds of videos. I make videos about fashion and beauty, homemaking, organization and decluttering, living simply, living minimally. Basically, I like sharing all of my interests and my life here on YouTube. So if you're interested, make sure to hit that subscribe button and stick around for more videos. Today, I'm gonna be just spending a couple of hours with you in the morning as I get things done around the house. I just dropped Ruben off at daycare, and usually while Maisie is putting herself down for her first nap, in the first like 10 to 15 minutes, I will quickly do what I can in the kitchen, do a quick tidy up of the kitchen, the dining area, and the play area. And I like to do a lot of little quick tidies throughout the day so that my mind can be at ease and I just feel less stressed when I come into a space that is clear. And I feel like after having two kids, I am even more so pushing like living minimally in my house because I just feel overwhelmed and stressed with all the stuff that comes in. And I'm really grateful for everything that comes in and all the gifts that people give us, but oftentimes it gets quite overwhelming, and that's why I do declutter quite frequently so that we are only keeping the things that we actually need and actually use. But anyway, we're not doing a decluttering video today. We are just gonna do some errands and some chores around the house. So let's get to it. I'm gonna continue tidying up the kids' space and also the kitchen. Before I get started, I'm gonna make my AG1 drink. This is not sponsored, but my husband and I bought it to try just to see if it helps with our overall health, because now that Ruben is in part-time daycare, he already got sick in his first week, and thankfully, JT and I didn't get sick. I don't know if it's because of AG1, maybe it has to do with it, maybe not, but it definitely does help me to get all my vitamins and greens in a single drink, which I like, instead of taking a bunch of different little pills. So I'm gonna make that, and then we'll get started with my chores. So next up, I'm gonna tackle some laundry. It is super gloomy and dark today, so just a lot of to turn on the lights and open the windows so I don't feel so like gloomy. I cannot wait for summer and the sun. I don't mind winter, but I don't love how cold it is and especially how gloomy it is. It makes me feel like more like dreary and like kind of blah, and I don't want to do anything. So the sun definitely helps with my mood for sure. I'm gonna empty out the dryer, so I'll be right back. All right, let's run upstairs and tidy up my bedroom. But first I'm gonna need my hands to pick up all this stuff that's on the stairs. All the diapers, and what is that? That's a sleeper. Let's bring it upstairs. All right, it's time for that bedroom tidy up time lapse. Let's go. All right, so yesterday I did some filming. Didn't get a chance to put away this stuff, so I'm gonna do that now. All right, the bedroom is all tidied up. I figured I would just show you my outfit while I'm here. I'm wearing the shelter cardigan in this garnet color. It is showing up a little bit more orangey and lighter red. It's a little bit darker in real life, and it's a little bit more blue, cool toned. It's showing up really like orangey here. Anyway, and then I'm wearing some light wash denim from Cotton. These were like the most comfortable postpartum. Now that I am like 6 months postpartum, it is a little bit baggier, but I still wear them. Super comfortable to kind of lounge around in and do everyday things. And I just like the look of the red with the light wash denim. So that is the look today. No earrings, just have my hair in a ponytail and very simple everyday makeup. That's it. I'm gonna bring these hangers down and hop back into the kitchen. All right, so I did a lot of tidying this morning. It is about 10:15 right now. I'm gonna get some lunch ready. I know it's really early. I just like to have it ready to go when Ruben comes home from daycare. And today, after Maisie wakes up from her nap, I actually need to run to the mall to return some items that I bought. So that's why I'm making the lunch now, so I can just reheat it later for when I'm back from pickup. All right, so today I am making some Korean beef with rice cakes, and I like to add some frozen vegetables in there as well because Ruben is not huge on meat and sometimes it's hard for him to chew. I know like most kids are not okay with vegetables, but Ruben's the opposite. He is like, he's not very good at taking in protein. So I try to give him peas and beans whenever I can. And I'm also gonna do an egg drop into the soup. So hopefully he'll be able to get some of that protein in that way. And he loves carbs, so I have rice cakes on the menu today. He loves rice cakes, rice, noodles. We typically eat a lot of that kind of stuff in our home. This is a super simple recipe that I love to do. It's not authentic because I'm not Korean, but this is, it's like Korean flavor inspired, I guess. This is pre-marinated Korean beef from Costco. And then I just have the rice cakes that I will put in. And then I like to make it kind of soupy with some water. And then I do an egg drop, which I will show you. So time for a little cooking segment with me, I guess. Alright, the reality of having a baby and toddler, sometimes we forget about things. So this pot, I used to steam some carrots last night for Maisie, and so I haven't washed it yet, so I'm gonna go ahead and wash this first. So first I'm just heating up a little bit of oil. You could use sesame oil as well, but since this beef is pre-marinated, I just thought I would stick with some just regular oil. Smells delicious. So another reason I wanted to do more like homemaking videos was so I could share more Asian inspired recipes for moms out there, because I find that like a lot of the homemaking videos are like very Western style meals, which is totally fine as well, but those are not the flavors that I grew up eating. And as a Canadian-born Asian, I'm not the best at like Chinese-style cooking. So I feel like a lot of these like fusion-style dishes are really great for my kids and that I like to eat as well. So I thought it'd be fun to share like what works for my family and for my toddler. And so if you're in the same boat trying to think of what to cook for your kids, I thought it'd be fun to share some more like Asian-inspired flavors. Definitely fusion, because I'm adding like frozen vegetables in, but you gotta do what you gotta do to get your kids to eat. So I just added frozen vegetables into the mix now, and I'm just cooking that up with the beef. Beef is like pretty much done, and I think at this point you can either add water or some kind of stock, but because again it's pre-marinated and I find that it's pretty salty already, I'm just gonna add some water. And then it'll be good. Alright, I'm just gonna grab a bowl. In our household, JT is definitely the better chef. I kind of just wing everything, so I'm just gonna grab this bowl and fill maybe like 2 or 3 bowls of this. So I'm gonna add the water in here to kind of like deglaze the pot. Is that what the chefs say? I really like watching cooking videos and cooking in general. Like, I love the Food Network, but I'm not the best chef, I will say. I'm decent. I can cook decent meals, I would say. All right, so now I'm just gonna let the like water boil up. I added 2 bowls of this. I'm gonna kind of let it boil up, and then I will add the egg drop in. So for the egg drop,
just use the same egg into the bowl. By the way, my dishes are all from Fable, so if you want to check it out, I have links, discount code down below as well. But yeah, so I'm gonna whisk it up in that same bowl. You can add one egg, two eggs. I'm just gonna add one because there's a lot of beef already. And then once the water bubbles, I'm gonna pour the egg mixture into the soup. So now the water is bubbling a bit. This is what the egg mixture is. And I'm gonna just pour in the egg mixture now. And just mix while I do that. We'll create like these beautiful ribbons of egg. Yum. So it's like a nice little beef stew. And another thing you could do instead of rice cakes is you could do the sweet potato noodles, which are really yummy, but I decided to do rice cakes because that's what I had on hand, and Ruben likes rice cakes. Yeah, I think it would be really yummy with sweet potato noodles as well. And that's it. All I gotta do is just cook up the rice cakes and throw them into the soup, and it'll be all ready. Now that it's bubbled, I'm just gonna cover it and it'll be ready for lunchtime. So one last thing I like to do to prep for when I come home from pickup is to prep a little fruit snack for Reuben. I like to do this because when I'm juggling two kids, it's just nice to have something to distract Reuben with so I can get Maisie upstairs for her nap. Pickup and drop off in the morning collide with her nap time, so it just gives me a little bit of a buffer when I come home. So yeah, I'm gonna prep some strawberries for him today so that he can have that as kind of part of his lunch. All right, fruit snack is prepped. Just gonna leave it there on the counter for him next to his standing tower. Cover it, because I'll be out for a while. All right, Maisie is starting to wake up from her nap. I was actually gonna wake her up anyway, but perfect timing. I hope you enjoyed this little glimpse into the first couple of hours that I have in my day. To be honest, today was an ideal day because Maisie put herself down. I was able to get so much done. This does not happen every day. The other day when I tried to film this on Monday, Maisie couldn't put herself down and JT had to hold her. Thankfully, he was home and I was able to film, but that was a whole other day. It looked completely different to the morning that I'm having right now. Just wanted to throw that out there so that you don't feel discouraged when you leave this video, because again, I never want anyone to feel discouraged leaving my channel. Motherhood is hard and it's so easy to get stuck in the trap of comparison. So what you see here is just literally one morning of my life. So I hope that you feel encouraged leaving this video, and if you enjoyed it, make sure to let me know in the comments down below, and I hope that you have a great day whatever time that you're watching this video. I will see you guys next time. Bye.